that are primitive, they are always exploitable. I don't know whether you understand what I mean. People that are primitive are always exploitable by very few. People that are ignorant are always exploited, just like what is happening in Nigeria, even in the northern and the southern part of that contraption called Nigeria. People are exploited because they are ignorant. And their exploiters, the politicians, they want the status quo to continue. Any attempt in order to open the eyes of the people are always met ferociously with their rights. But here on Radio Biafra, we are consistent and we must continue. Remember, the Europeans were in the Dark Ages. You know, when you Google, check your Google, Dark Ages. It doesn't mean that that time was that there was darkness that covered, darkness covered the world. No, 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 no. The darkness is in the brain. The darkness is in the brain. Do you understand? So, but the Europeans were able to come to light via enlightenment. Light was shined in that dark part of their brain and they became enlightened. That is what we are doing here. It takes more than a man to do what we are doing. And it takes somebody highly courageous to understand what we are saying here. Somebody with a dose of common sense. That is why we invite you to come here with a dose of your common sense in order to listen to what we are saying. Without wasting time, I must call down the name of Chukwuka Abiamah to hand over this project into his care. Our Father who art in heaven, the creator of the whole universe, we have once again gathered in this hallowed platform in order to speak the truth and nothing but the truth. Because it is the truth that enlightens people. There are forces of darkness everywhere that are feeding, benefiting on the miseries of the ignorant in Nigeria. But here, in this hallowed platform, we are shining light on the darkness, in the mindset, in the conscience, in the brains of people, so that they will embrace the light. Chukwuka Abiamah, I present our leader Mazi Nnamdi Okwuchukwu Kanu into your care. The whole principal officers of the indigenous people and all the Biafrans into your care. Even those other non-Biafrans and other nations that are yearning for liberation. Lord in heaven, hear, O ye Lord, Chukwuka Abiamah, from wherever you abide, because I believe that you are nearer to us than everything. Therefore, hear our voices. The Fulani Caliphate has taken over Nigeria, and they are intimidating, killing, trying to deliver everybody through our local politicians. But Lord in heaven, here we resist. Here we make sure that we expose them as they are. Because you have given us the power, the force, the authority to do so. Therefore, guide us, O God, in everything we are doing. And let people that listen to this message of redemption and freedom, have change of heart and embrace the light. Thank you, Chukwuka Abiamah, for in your name we have prayed. He said, once again I welcome each and every one of you to today's edition of Radio Biafra.
Your WhatsApp group, all over the world, I've seen it, all over that scene. But that alone is not going to anyway. I'm not in a group. Just few people in the group. There are not many. But if you can pay attention, if you can dedicate this ourselves to this Radio Biafra, We can more than 10 million people are listening to that. So it could be one of us who can be listening to them at the same time. So Kanigi, when I guess when I saw the woman, really Biafra. But is Benny. Yakamata Utashi, Yakamata Mugani, Chiawa, Lokuchin Yazo, and this platform is the right time, the right platform. One of them had a came with Chiawa, who unite Namu, Musenka Chiawa, Muni Igon, Chiawa, Murigamu Tashiko. Because Munukafia and Nassau State. So is that a because those 10 secretary, anywhere they go, they will first identify with the majority of that state. Because the moment they conquer the majority, those minority are nothing. That's why when they come to Nassau, they discover that we, the Igon people, we are the majority. That's why they try to conquer us first. You see me? So that's why they try to conquer us and impose Islam to divide us. Because without division, they will not penetrate. That's why they can some go to Muslim, some go to Christian. So that what is the issue? We will not have plans with ourselves. Religion is not a problem. Religion is not a problem. Ego is a good man. Whether you go, whatever, ego is, we are all one. But we have to be very careful. We have to be very careful and very observant. So that where this is going today, because since that they know that why can't you impose some religion for other ethnic group? No. Can you imagine the whole of our state would even have a government? The only kind of government give us the rule that we are more than 1.5 million people in our state. So they know that we don't want to conquer the our state. And the only way they will do it, they have to conquer the majority first. And we are the majority. So we are not going to allow that. So if it happened before, that we don't have platform. With this now, we have a platform. So we are going to stand firmly. We are going to work hard. We are going to work in unity. We are going to work in harmony. We are going to unite all the good people. And whatever you are, anywhere you be, anywhere you be, all of us will unite, we will do it together. So that's why we'll come every day, so we'll talk about our unity, we'll talk about our progress, we'll talk about our own. So that's why I say make a small time. Come here today and talk small. So that, but this program, if you like, make talk say, make people not come comment. But me, I'm here, and I will be talking every day until everybody has to understand. And I believe our people, they will understand. The youth, they will by follow the elders, because if you have to follow them, you will not agree. I will know. So, but we have to use our head. We need to use our brain, because it's our time. It's our generation. So, from this generation onward, now Igon people must be noticed. Even people, they must believe what they know us. They must know us. So I come in every day to talk about Igon unity progress. So now here I want to draw cutting. Maybe after I'm speaking after about handing my foot to my other continue. Maybe I should come back after to come and end up. Then let us call. Which my organ will give the number letter. Continue. So let me drop for you here. You want to complete the program. Thank you very much. Once again, my name is myself, Jacob. I'm a Igon by tribe from Nassau State. Proud Igon man. I want to say man. Oh, welcome man. So let me look up to say, this guy, he's not even man. No, he's like, Igon. No, that's a lie. I'm not going. Go. What is it? Mazi.
Thank you very much for your submission. Thank you very much, Mazi Jacob, Embassy from Nassau State. We must continue. This is Radio Biafra House Service coming to you through the auspices of Radio Biafra London. I urge any other people, be you in Ariwan, be you Hausa, be you from Middle Belt, Karakafa, republic, anything you call it. This radio, this platform is your platform. You should join in to take your rightful position. As far as you are yearning for freedom, as far as you are there to make sure that people are enlightened, I urge you to join, to come to this platform, because this is the voice of freedom. This is not only the voice of Igbos or Biafrans, as you can call it now, because people are changing the narrative by making it look like, oh, why are you joining them? This is Igbo something, this and that. No. That is where, you know, I say again, the most difficult thing in life is to change people's mentality. Once you positively change people's mentality, that is enlightenment, it's finished. You develop a nation, I'm telling you. That is it. Because when you look at what is happening in Nigeria, the impunity going on in Nigeria, do you know what? Do you know the cause, the reason, or the cause, I should say? It's not because of the politicians, they are stealing this and that. Yes, they are stealing. Yes, they are killing. Yes, they are corrupt. But do you know why? The people, millions of people, the ordinary people, the masses are not enlightened enough. They are still ignorant. Only very few might be enlightened, and that very few is not enough. Do you understand? That is the reason why NSAS protest was halted, because of the ignorance of people. Let me say it again. The ignorance of people is the reason why this NSAS protest that should have resulted into a full-blown revolution to throw out all these shenanigans, all these politicians, all these criminals that we call politicians. Because people are ignorant. That is why they sow the seed of discord, the politicians. They know how to fight back. They sow tribal seed of discord in a place you call a country. But after, in one way they say, no, become a good Nigerian, a Nigerian. In another way, when it fits them, they say, you are an Igbo, you are Yoruba, you are Hausa, you are a gun. When it suits them, for their own political motive, for their benefit. When it suits them, they say, no, don't know, you are a Nigerian. No, you are a Nigerian. Yeah, put the tribalized Nigerian. But when it suits them, they also sow the seed of tribe, which is also what I'm going to talk about today. Therefore, the reason why things are continuing as it is, the reason why there is no electricity in Nigeria, the reason why things are not moving on well, is because of the ignorance of the majority of the people. As simple as that. If the majority of the people are enlightened before God and man, within 24 hours they will sweep away all these fields that we call politicians in Nigeria. They are debts, you know, fields. You know how when a room is dirty, you use broom or use a electric cleaner. You use broom, just sweep it off. Do you understand? That is how these fields we call politicians in Nigeria should be swept off. But you know why? You know why things are going like that as they are today? Because majority of the people, they are still ignorant. Whenever a proper somebody will enter political office as a poor person, in the next 24 hours, he will start building mansions everywhere, and people will be clapping. You know what people will be saying? I tap for your blessing, hey, let God give. You know, they'll be preaching in churches and in religious places, miracle, to be like Mr. X. You know, his miracle is now. You know, because he is looted. They call it miracle. You know why people accept all this nonsense? Because people are ignorant. That's only fact. Instead of them to rise up to fight and kill those that are doing all these things, they clap for them. They pray to God to be like them, oh, so that I will enter and start stealing. That is, after once you start stealing, you enter political office, you start stealing, your local pastor, your daddy Gio will praise God for you, giving example with you. As one of those, you see, the your miracle, he prayed for you, your miracle has started happening. And that's why you're chairman, a local government chairman. And that's why, you know, see, look at now, you are going with your motorcade. You are building mansions everywhere because people are ignorant. Majority of the people are ignorant. And they clap. They pray to I don't know who. Saying, God, I want to be like this Luther. Let my miracle be. Do you see what we call ignorance? We are here to enlighten you so that you understand the basis of your problems. Oh, I don't have job. Oh, I've been a graduate. I've graduated since 10 years. No work. Now I'm on Okada riding. You go to church, you pray, you go to mosque, you pray, you go to any religious ground, shrine, you pray for miracle so that you enter office and be admitted and start looting. So that you have a contract, you get a contract, a government contract, whereby something you can do with 1 million naira, they will inflate it to 10 billion. And you say, yes, my miracle has started. Praise God, my miracle is here now. Not knowing that you are a simple criminal. Do you see the reason why, personally, I say that, you know, all this religion in Nigeria, it plays negative roles, mostly, I'm telling you. It's not what I'm talking about today anyway. This is just a preamble. Let me continue by making my normal, usual remark. Please stop calling these people the House of Fulani. There is nothing like House of Fulani. What we have are Hausas and Fulani as different tribes, different nations, different ethnic groups. The Hausas are a majority. They are populous. They are a majority tribe in Nigeria. Whereas the Fulani, they are very minority, minute. But it will amaze you how the Fulani conquered the Hausas. That time, I know the Fulani, they were not even up to 200,000 in Hausa land. They are not up to, I'm telling you. Whereas Hausas count in their millions. But it will amaze you how the Fulani conquered the Hausas. They were able to enter into their mentality, their psyche. They manipulated them mentally using religion. This is why religion can be good and bad. It depends on how you use it. You understand that? The Fulani, they use religion to Islamic religion to enter into the Hausas. The Hausas that have been Muslims since 11th century, almost 1,000 years, even before the history of the presence of Fulani in their region. But they allow these people to use religion to enter into them. Religion they knew. Their lifestyle that have been good, very hard-working houses. Now they allow foreigners to manipulate them mentally. The same way even we indigenous population that allowed foreigners, the British, the Europeans, to manipulate us religiously. And we are suffering it today. We jettison our way of life. We completely, not only jettisoning it, we start fighting against our way of life. That is the evil in it. The evil part of it, I mean. We swallowed everything they told us, hook, line, and sinker. Even to this extent, people believe that we don't have Chukwukabiyama is not an idol or anything they can call it. Which means we don't even have the name of God in our language. Only when you call it in English. Just the same way the Hausas, the Fulani, they erase their own language by calling God, which means they didn't know God before the advent of Islam. Now they call it Arabic. It's Arabic, Allah. It's Arabic way of calling God. Allah is Arabic. It's written in Arab. It's pronounced in Arab. The first people to call it, that is the supreme God, call it Allah. In all these things, they contribute to the fact that people, you are inferior to them. Because you're a human being normally, you're a people, you communicate with your people in your own languages, you pray in your own way to God. But the Arabs came and said, no, everything you are doing is wrong. This is Allah, call it Allah, not if call it in Arabic, and you continue calling it here in Arabic till death. Do you see what we make you to understand here? Now the Fulanis, they manipulated the Hausas, because King Yulfa in 1804 or before 1804 allowed Otman Danfodio, who was born in Gobe by his Fulani parents that we are tenants to the Hausa in Gobe, the present day Sokoto, and they allowed him to start playing with their mindset, telling them that this Islam you are practicing, your leaders are corrupt, why are you living with unbelievers, why are you going to unbelievers marriages? Well, they say no, but they are our sisters and brothers. This Ottoman Danfodio shut them down. No, a Muslim should be a Muslim. An infidel is an infidel. It doesn't matter. Even if it's your brother, as far as he doesn't believe in what you believe, though it's not a Muslim, he's no more your brother. He turned the people against themselves, the same way the British taught us using the missionaries in our land. That these people are our believers, and no, we are believers. Now they take Oyibo. I'm saying these things in two ways. Why I'm talking about the Ottoman Danfodio Fulani Hausa system, I am also referring it to our system, because what happened to the Hausas happened to us in a way. You understand? So they tell them that, look, Ottoman Danfodio said, no, you Hausa people, why are you, your kings are not, they are corrupt people. They are not worshipping in the right Islamic way. Otherwise, they would have killed the whole unbelievers. They say, no, but it's our brothers and sisters. They say, no, according to Quran, they say that you, an unbeliever is an unbeliever. Don't do it. Don't do anything with him. The same way they told us also, have no, it's in the Bible. You don't have anything in accord with unbelievers. It's in the book of Galatians. Do you see that? So they separated you from your brothers. That is when things, Junior said at Chebero, he said that is when you know that things have fallen apart in our land. So that when we are talking about how the Fulani manipulated the Hausas, I am also talking about how they manipulated us. That is why today there is nothing like ordinary again. People are no more following the rules of the land. Instead, they are clannish in our land. Division. Brother against sister. Pastor will tell you that your problem is from your uncle, it's from your brother. You see enmities in them. Thank God I'm seeing people are bringing all these charlatans that call themselves pastors. they are revealing many of them. I saw somebody, is it Paul, I don't know, from, is it in Akwa Ibom across River State, being revealed, another person also, another charlatan, calling himself a pastor or man of God. I think in Enugu was caught. These are ritualists. But they are doing everything in the name of Jesus. And you fall. A miracle has come. Why are these people deceiving? Why? Because things has fallen apart. People now believe that anything that is our own local thing, our own local, even the way we call Chukwu, they say, no, it's an idol. You call Chukwu Abiyama, somebody, an Igbo man will say it's an idol. The same way Ottoman Danfodio deceived the Hausas and conquered them. That is how we are today. It's sad, but it's truth. It's truth. The Fulanis manipulated the mindset, the mentality of the Hausas, turning them against each other. And when they were fighting, killing themselves, the Fulanis took over everything. Now, as they took over the Hausa land, they killed any opposition. Any person that we oppose them, they slaughtered him. Now they turn any other Hausa person into slaves till today. They made sure that they held them on the ground by making them once an Hausa person is born, 2 years, as long as once your mother stops giving you breast, once you are weaned, they will send you to the Fulani Malam. You become an Amajiri. There they will brainwash you for you to know that the Fulani is superior to you, that the Fulani brought Islam to you, that they should be your king, that the Fulani should be your ruler, that the Fulani should do anything that is, you should be under the Fulani. That is what they have done to the Hausas. No pity, they don't pity them. Listen, for you to be strong, somebody must be down. That is it. That is the rule of the world. The Hausas are down, the Fulanis took over. A very minute set of people. That is what happened. And they cleverly put this word, Hausa Fulani. They brought it out. In order to continue making the Hausas feel that, we are one people. We are one people. Do you see that? Because the Hausas are more populous. But by far, the Fulanis are not up to 7 million in Nigeria. No matter the way they are bloating their figures, they are not up to 7 million in Nigeria, controlling Hausas that are 40 something million. Do you see how is that? Because the Fulani, they know how to play their political game. They know that. Now they parasitize themselves, wrap around the Hausas, leaving the house only the language, which makes the Hausas very more happy. Oh, to accept that these people, we are together. Anything against the house, against the Fulani is against the Hausa. Now, anywhere they commit atrocities, the Fulani commit atrocities using Hausa language. And the local people will hate the Hausa the way they hate the Fulani. Even hate the Hausa more. Do you see that? But when the benefits come, you see the Fulani will rise up and take the benefit, segregate it. Because the Fulani are very nepotistic. I say number one nepotistic in the whole of West Africa. Go and make your research. The Fulani, they are nepotistic. You understand that? And they keep themselves that unity by force against themselves. If you're Fulani, you convert to another religion, be it Christianity or Hindu, you will be no more. You are declared wanted to be killed by anybody that will kill you, any Fulani person that will kill you, it has a reward. That is how they impose unity on themselves. And that is a good politics, I should tell you. And that is why they're on top. Because you cannot continue playing with the lives of a whole nation. When I call a nation, it's a tribe. It's the same thing. Nation and tribe is the same thing. Ethnic group. Because of your selfishness or selfish, you want to defeat, they will cut off your head and you are gone. Others will be afraid. Do you understand? Do you understand that? That is why the Fulani, they don't have a free mind. You will see some of them, even they want to, they hate even their version of religion. But they don't dare come out or to change to Christian or this and that. No. It's a no-go area. They will tell you, we are forced to remain like this, so we remain like this. Because if you change tomorrow, they want him and kill or her. Because they don't want anything that will bring, loophole onto them. The same way the Japanese try to protect their country, their people, themselves, their nation. When the Europeans first arrived in Japan in the early 15th century, the same way, they made a decree. Any Japanese that do what accepts Christianity, he will be killed. Him, not only him, him and the family. All his family will be burned alive, killed. They practiced this for 265 years. They know what they are doing. Protecting a race is not easy. Because if they didn't do it, what is happening in our land will happen to them. Everybody will become a Zonyagwana. Oh, go like this, go in front, the other one is going backward. This one is in mountain of fire. This one is fire in the mountain. This one is in the Redeemer organization. The other one is evangelistic limited. Everybody will be just look at our land today. Are you happy about it? That is when we accept things without no regulation. Now everybody is a master of his own. Don't tell me this and that. Evil multiplies and the whole race is going down and down, becoming slaves to others. So please let us do the right thing. There is nothing like Hausa Fulani. What we have are Hausa and Fulani. Separate them, they are not the same set of people. Today I'm going to talk about a little bit about nation, that is tribes and country. Nation and country, for you to understand these words, what it means. Because many people are misusing all these words. You know, a tribe or a nation is defined as a social division in a traditional society consisting of families or communities linked by social, economic, religious, or blood ties with a common culture and dialect. A common culture and dialect. That is what makes a tribe or a nation. Because a tribe and nation or ethnic group is separate. Forget about refine it. You know, when they call a village and countryside, it's the same thing. Only that they put it in a refined English. They call it, in Africa, they call it a village. But in the Western world, it is countryside. That is it. That is the same thing with tribe and nation. Also, a nation, a tribe can be aggregates of people united by ties of descent from a common ancestor, a community of customs and tradition. All these are pointing together. People with common ancestry. They have blood ties. That is a nation, a tribe. Whereas a country is a nation or nations with its own government occupying a particular territory. Listen, it's just like Nigeria. Nigeria is a country. But you know, because of sometimes misuse of words, people call it nation. It's not a nation. Nigeria is not, it's never a nation. It's a country, a contraption even. I'm coming. Also, a country is a political state or territory which is controlled. A controlled political state or territory comprising of nations. A nation or nations. Because a nation can also make a country. You understand? Or nations can form a country, just like you have in the United Kingdom. You know, but what is terrible? What is terribly wrong in the case of Nigeria. Nigeria is a country, yes. But the problem we have with Nigeria is what? Foreigners came in. They formed a country without the consent of the people. Not that Britain conquered everybody and continue ruling everybody. It would have been better. Do you understand? There wouldn't have been no problem, because they would have even induced, they would have, you know, had it been Britain continue occupying Nigeria, ruling Nigeria, there would be no qualms about it. But they left Nigeria, they left at this entity. They came, it wasn't Nigeria. They formed in Nigeria by force, without the consent or the sensitivities of the indigenous population. That is where lies the problem. And now they left, selling everybody to one particular tribe. Do you understand? That is the terrible wickedness that we have been talking against. Listen, it might interest you to know, in the United States of America, because if I am analyzing, I will also go into the mindset of some people that will pose some questions, but I will answer it, because some people will say, okay, like in United States, there are tribes. Currently, we have tribes in the United States, indigenous population. We have tribes like the Shawnee tribe. These are Indian tribes in Oklahoma. We have the Agua Caliente band. These are Indian tribe also. Indian tribes. Akchin Indian community. Alabama Kushata tribe of Texas. These are tribes that are currently in the United States. But do you know the difference? Let me tell you, these tribes are there. Foreigners came, they conquered them. Foreigners conquered them and continue living with them, creating their own country, creating a country which they are developing with their value systems. Foreigners didn't leave, the British didn't leave. Instead, they join forces with the locals and say, we now want to be independent. Just like exactly what they did in South Africa. South Africa, they became independent of Britain in 19th century. Sorry, is it in 20th century? Or either early 19th century or 20th century, if I'm not mistaken. I'm in South Africa. And after the Second World War, the South African white government now imposed what we call apartheid system of government. No matter what, because they want to uphold their development, the European development, as against the so-called, the way they put it, let me put it in their words, the black primitive people. Because if they didn't use that appetite, they wouldn't have developed to the extent of South Africa today. I don't know whether people understand what I'm saying. These white South Africans, these white Europeans that later call themselves South Africans, they were there on ground building the country. They built and developed the country. No matter that they subjugated the blacks, yes, but they are there on ground. Because what they are doing for the country, because they are living there in the country, they are on the ground. They want to make everywhere a better place. Because they feel that the black Africans in their midst is a hindrance. If they give them the black South Africans the freedom that all of them have, because they saw these people as, these are a thin set of people. They are still in the dark ages. So we need to teach them one place in order to develop our country. Do you understand what I mean? Because they feel that without teaching the blacks, I'm not insulting them, but I'm just telling you what is in the mindset of the white Europeans that we are living, they are still living in South Africa. That is how you see South Africa developed. Do you see during the independence, before independence in many African countries, even in West Africa, even in Nigeria, there were many developments as of that time, competing with even that of Western world as of that time. They built hospitals everywhere in the rural areas. These are white people. These are people that are ruling us over us. But at least they were giving us development more than what we are having today. Had it been Britain was still ruling Nigeria, they would have at least removed this Fulani hegemony. They would have at least subdued it, and everybody would, no matter that there would be apartheid government, but you would have seen development. Had it been the British, we are living in our midst in Nigeria till death. But the evil wickedness in Nigeria, they committed by the British, is they left, they came, they conquered us. Instead of ruling us completely directly, even without giving us independence, rule just like South Africa. Now they carried us, forced us into a country that could not be. People with that, primitive people, force us to stay together with people we don't know. When Tafawa Pelewa and Ahmad Bello warned them that what you are doing is not human, it's not organic. Nigeria unity is in your figment of imagination. At least they told them the truth. I used to hammer on this, and it is a fact. Do you understand that? We should never shy away from the truth. I say again, if people that know before independence, because I myself, I know till 1980s when at least I know something. I saw that there are sick beds, what they call sick bed, in many villages, interior villages, where people, they are sick, they go there, they deliver or they get treatment. You say they were built by Oyibo. They were built by the whites, by British. But today you cannot see all these things again. They built railway lines. There were electricities at least in many places. We hear when our leader Mazi Nnamdi Kanu used to say that in his alma mater, in Umuahia, in the school, at least before there was Oyibo piped water into their school. But everything now is damaged because primitive Neanderthals are in charge. Do you understand? Do you see the reason why they cage the South African indigenous population? Why they develop? Do you know that South Africa had the capacity of building nuclear weapon? Do you know that? Do you know that? tell me any black African country that have this capacity. People are running into South Africa, going there, doing one business or the other, because the white people, Europeans, developed it, because they are on the ground living there. Do you understand that? That is what happened in the United States. They have many tribes. Many of them are wiped off. Many of them are still having very few remaining. But the Europeans that conquered them are there. And even those people now, they are proud to be American citizens, Americans. Do you understand? They are no more called the Cherokee. They are not even, they cannot come out and proudly call themselves their tribal name. Oh, the Aguachilante. Oh, the Shawnee. I'm a Shawnee tribe. No, they call themselves United States of America. Because the Europeans are still there. The people that conquered them developed there by force, brought it to their test, and today they are the most powerful country in the whole world. Had it been, they were being left into the hands of the indigenous people, they wouldn't have built it like this. So that is the difference in Nigeria. Had it been British are here and there on ground in Nigeria, living and doing businesses there, living as taking there as their country, they would have built it. We wouldn't have too much qualms, no matter. But what is evil is that they left, they sold us, they forced us to be together, divergent people with divergent value system. Do you know the meaning of divergent? Do you know the meaning? Because whenever we talk, it's tending to be different, develop in different directions. That is, you know, this one going to A, the other north, the other side, south, the other, you know, with no single focus. That is jaga-jaga. That people with divergent values. The people don't even care to do what the Indians did. You know, we hammer this every day so that it will enter into the medulla oblongata of people, to the mind, the brain of people, to understand the reality, the real issue of Nigeria, why we are doing what we are doing. There is no day they call the indigenous people, even they themselves call themselves, to negotiate and say, look, okay, Britain has brought us together, whether by force or with one ideology or with one, influence or with one mindset or another. What their plan, we don't know. But it is for us now to behave like human beings, to negotiate, are we going to stay here or under what terms? Or do we call it a quit to your debts, O Israel? So that we continue being what we were before these people came. Do you know that countries in Asia, they did that? India, they did that with Pakistan. When Britain colonized India, they huddled them together as one Asian giant zoo, the biggest zoo in the whole world they would have been. Because what Britain is looking for is just territory. Any territory with the hearts of human beings doesn't matter to them, that human beings, indigenous people, doesn't matter to them. They are looking for territory. Oh, just like when in a place whereby everybody goes scramble for territories. Any land you get is yours. You farm. Now you start running around, oh, I have 12 acres. This is my land. You don't care, because the more land you have, the more farm you get, the more things you cultivate, the more richer you become. So that is what Europeans did, the British. They hoarded Pakistan, India, the Pashtuns, the Hindi, and the Urdu. They hoarded them together. Do you understand that? They didn't care about the sensitivities of all those indigenous communities, indigenous people. But they said this is, they ruled them as one people, just like Nigeria, holding them together. But do you know what? Little did the British know that these people, they have sense, so they are human beings. You know, they are colored people. They have white color, so they have sense. Sometimes I think, why black people, why are we docile? Why we don't even regard or pity ourselves by doing the right thing? By at least showing that now we follow. I so quick putting on why. Anywhere they push us, we stay. Why? Listen. When India and Pakistan and Bangladesh, These are different. Mostly India is mostly Hindi by tribe, mostly. They have other minorities, Bengali and the rest, but they have Hindi as most. Now in Pakistan, they have Pashtun. In Bangladesh, they have Urdu. That is their languages they speak. That is their tribe, who they were, who they are. Not who they were, who they are, who they still are. So, but Britain didn't care because they were fighting for territory. They huddled them together and said, you people are one. Had it been, they continue being like that. You know what India, you know what they will be fighting till today? One India. Because that is a disease, like one Nigeria. It is a gift of Britain to continue fighting for one Nigeria till thy kingdom come. Fight for, even if you kill a whole race, kill them as far as you are fighting for one Nigeria. That is what Britain tried to institute in India. But the Indians, they prove to the British that they have common sense. Come on. That is the difference. That is why you go to India, you see many Nigerians, many Africans. Even you see people going to India to do plastic surgery. You know the reason? They have common sense. When at independence in 1947, two countries emerged at the same time. Britain wanted them to stay together, but they emerged as two countries, India and Pakistan. They told themselves that, look, we cannot stay like this because this is not who we are. Negotiated with themselves. The same thing Ahmad Bello, Azikiwe and Awolowo should have done. They should have had meeting among them, say, look, these are foreigners, they are imposing us to be one. I think that even Ahmad Bello, Atafao Belewa, they wanted that negotiation. I'm telling you before God and man. That is what I, because of when you study history, their body movements, the way they talk, they wanted this negotiation so that everybody will go his way. Or if we are going to stay together now, under what terms? Because they were playing in their outbursts. They were saying things that, yes, if you're a reasonable person, you should understand that, look, these people, we should negotiate or we separate. Finish. When somebody tells the British, tell people that, look, this thing you are trying to create, this Britain, what you are trying to create is catastrophic. This thing you are creating is catastrophic. How can you put us together? We don't know ourselves. We didn't know ourselves. We don't have no common culture, no common religion. We didn't believe in anything commonly. Our ideology is different. Now you want to force us to be together. This togetherness, this unity is just your imagination. So we cannot be. Even Awolowo agreed on it, say Nigeria is just a geographical entity. Now, for reasonable people, Is it not better for them to have negotiated and say, look, we should call it a quit. We should do what India did. India today is progressing. All of them are progressing in their own basis. They are now nuclear powers. India, Pakistan, Bangladesh is progressing. At least when you talk about textile, they are there. What made in Bangladesh. At least in their own pace, in their own way, there is no friction among them. Because they are two different, they are different countries. Three different countries that would have been a very big zoo. That's why I'm talking about nations, tribes, and country. So when you talk about America, there are tribes in America, yes, till death. But those people now, they are even thanking them for God for these foreigners to be in their midst, to develop them. Because they are having the highest development. Do you understand? Had it been the Europeans are in our midst today, it will not be easy, yes. But Nigeria wouldn't have been without electricity. Because these are people that have common sense. Although they will impose apartheid on the indigenous people. Because for them to develop, they have to impose apartheid government. Otherwise, blacks, because due to their way of reasoning, they are retarded. They are retarded in their way of reasoning. They will spoil everything. So, in order to get them, they would have done what South African white people did in South Africa by imposing an apartheid law. Look at South Africa today, they give to blacks. They are reversing everything, little by little. If care is not taken in, then unless the presence of white people are there anyway, they are there. Otherwise, if not, in the next 30, 40 years, they will become the same thing. Oh my God. So, this is why I'm talking about national tribes and countries, for you to understand the evil that happened in our land. They forced us to live together. We are forced to live together by foreigners. That is evil. Without even having our opinion about our life. No, continue living to. And the worst part of it is that we are fighting. People are defending this. Why? Because they love the status quo. Because of what they are getting from the status quo. Now everybody is talking about one Nigeria. All these politicians, look at them. In Nigeria, there is never a local consensus about Nigeria. This is the main problem. Do you understand that? We are suffering today because we are forced. This is a racist construct. As our leader said it, it is true. Nigeria is a racist construct. How can you force people to live together? It's just like forced marriage. Look at forced marriage. You carry a child, push it to a boy or a man that he don't even abhor, two of them to live in the same house. What do you get? Either one will kill the other. I'm telling you. That is it. That is first marriage, the first on us. And that is why we in South are looking for progress, development. The North is busy looking to conquer everybody first. That is their priority. Conquering. Subduing everybody. So that they do to us what the white men should have done to us. That is what the Fulani is doing. To conquer. Because I didn't believe when they conquer us, they cage us. Apartheid government. That is what we are running in Nigeria. Apartheid government. Forget about politicians that come from your side, from South. Look at what they did to South, so-called South governors. Just look at, just imagine what they did to them. Imagine. Why? Why did they do it? Because these people, they saw them what do you call them? They see them as slaves. People without, there is nothing, they don't owe them any apology. Do you understand? People with inconsequential. That is what they, I want to search the video. An eight, because it is appalling. All these things will be happening, but still, will they have sense? No way, they don't have sense. Please, I want you to listen. The South, so-called South. You know, what baffles me is this. When they want to hold governors forum meeting in the North, they call it the North. The North. You know, in Nigeria, we have a six geopolitical zones. Northeast, North Central, Northwest. Okay. Now, Southeast, Southwest, and South. That is six. Does it occur to you? Does it not baffle you? If they are doing meeting in the north, they call it the north. There is no geopolitical zone, no north central, no north east, no north west, they call it north. Albeit that they are imposing on the north central, that is middle belt. It shouldn't be north, it should be central Nigeria. But they impose on them. You know, politics is a game of numbers. Now, doesn't it baffle you? If there is any meeting in the south, you have Southwest Governors Forum. You have a South-South Governors Forum. And you have Southeast Governors Forum. Doing their things differently. Why then? I want to steer people's conscience and thinking. People's brain just start thinking. Why is it so? In the north, they have north central, they have north east, they have north west. But when they want to have meeting governors forum, they say northern governors forum. Mighty northern governors forum. Whereas in the south, when they want to have their meeting southwest, we have their own meeting separate. Southeast separate. South south separate. Now you tell me, who is the wiser? I used to prick your conscience with this question. People, you say they don't know anything. They are more politically wise by 1,000% than you. Do you understand? They are playing British. I mean, they are playing, yes, British against us, the South. Do you understand what is happening? They are playing Lord against us. That is why they make sure that everywhere is separated, because they know that the unity we stand, but divided we fail. That is why we are fallen. Does it occur to you, why is it that everybody is shouting, every region in the south is shouting, oh, Fulani, they are killing us. So called North Central, which is central middle belt, they cry even more. Northwest, Oduduwaland, so called South-South, with South-East, which is Biafra land, is crying. But they cannot solidly stand one place and take a decisive decision solidly as a bunch. No. Now, why can't you ask yourself, what is the problem? Because these people are highly primitive. These are people you can control with money, with political power, with they are selfish. Selfishness is in their blood. Who are you going to tell? Who are you going to talk to listen to you? Who? Just tell me who. We see it in our midst. Why? Everybody is saying, don't talk to me, I know more than you. Don't talk. And we are divided in pieces. And all of us are suffering the same thing. Look at the South-South governor, so-called. Even there is no cardinal point called South-South. But listen to them, please, before I continue. They had a meeting whereby the people should be there or send delegates as they did to Southeast and Southwest. You know, the so-called South-South, they don't know that even they take them as, the Fulani see them as the most useless slaves. I'm telling you. they don't know. It's part of their land. It's not an insult. It's truth. They even take them as the most useless left, because for them these people doesn't matter. They don't count because of the way some of them reasons. They are politicians. They are fighting with their fighting. They are. They don't even understand where they are. They create Nigeria, or you don't create Nigeria, and we are fighting against Nigeria identity. Now these people Fulani created them. Now they are grappling with their Fulani creation. I'm reverse man. If I'm reading something I hear, we are not Igbos, we are rivers. I wonder. The other day I was reading something like that. I cannot even read it, I just leave it. Because I know the writer is as ignorant as anything you can think about. Primitive. That is how the Fulani detect them as nothing. Not in your nothing. That is why they disgrace them. But they can do nothing. They keep them waiting. They kept them waiting. Governors. Oh, Your Excellency. They kept waiting. They are waiting for. Asura was there. Even they forgot. They say, but you have a rendezvous. You have an appointment with these people. I'll follow you with them. The presidency. Igaraba Shehu and Co. Tell them, who are those people, sir? Tell them, I beg. Tell them that we have come after staying for more than 3 hours. Tell them that we have cancelled the meeting. Who are they? All these people. I beg. Because he's so weak that he immediately denounced who he is because of political position. These people are grappling with their identity first. They don't even know where they belong to first. So how will somebody respect you? How? Just tell me how. How will the Fulani respect you? At least you never even know you are. You are calling yourself a Rivers man. Oh, I'm Bayelsa man. What is Bayelsa? What is Rivers? That is why the Fulani, they don't. They even let these people pray. We have beer for otherwise. Fulani, what Fulani will do to them? Oh God Almighty! They will chop them raw. Because you know. Other parts of Biafra land is just like buffer zone to them. That is what they are. Because anything that happened to them, all Biafrans rise up. That is why. If they succeed in removing some part of these people from Biafra land, God damn it. You see how they deal with even some of them that we are sent from as refugees from Bayelsa. You see how they dump them in. Is it the Bayelsa or Rivers house in Lagos? Forgot them. Because they don't even, Fulani don't even see them as normal human being, I'm telling you. That is why they are treating everybody like this. Listen, as they are shouting like rat. Listen, please.
Enough of the insult.
Insult. When you
insult yourself. Yes, let's not say this meeting, no, go ahead. Because everything about Niger Delta is a joke.
You know why it's a joke? You are right. Because they created you, Niger Delta. We are shouting of Nigeria that is not our identity. Now, inside Nigeria, all the tribe created you and you are happy answering it. Oh, we are Niger Delta. It's a joke. Everything about Niger Delta is a joke. It's a complete joke. It's true. You are right there. It's true. Continue listening.
A joke.
It's true. Why would they give you South-South? South-South, that is, you know what, you know, these people don't understand even significance of things because of their selfishness and wickedness. That is why they answer something that doesn't exist. It's just like when you bring up your son and call him Zero. Zero. It doesn't exist. You create a place, they created you calling you South-South just for you to be away from your brethren and you answer. You know that there is nothing like South-South in existence and you answer it. Just because of your ignorance, primitivity and selfishness, you answer. At least you must have said to them, no, we cannot answer something that doesn't exist. Please. Change it to another thing, even if it is South is South. Okay, it's in existence. South is South. At least a semblance of something existing. But they call you something, you are nothing. Just like they call you name now, say, what is your name? Nothing. Your name is nothing. And you answer because you want to run away from your brother. You are running from your shadow. Why will you be existential? You are right.
It's the show, say.
You are right. Everything is
enough of the insult.
Listen again.
Me, I first know, say this meeting, no, go ahead. Because everything about Niger Delta, na joke.
Okay.
Everything about South, na joke.
Na joke, because you don't. Because you know why it's joke? Because that name doesn't exist. It's something coined. It's just like Inside Nigeria now, they start calling you Niger Delta, South South. It makes you understand that you don't exist. You are zero in their mindset. It's another way of calling you. You are zero, not zero. Zero. You don't exist. And you answer it. Is it now you are knowing it that anything, everything about South South is a joke? It doesn't exist. You don't know. Listen.
Say, when I respect South South, no can I not pick any call from presidency, at least within the next 24 hours.
He's telling them not to pick any call from the presidency. Look at them, they are laughing. Look at, as they are talking now, even the presidency, because it's presidency, is like, they don't, it's like they say, who are these rats, self? let them know, presidency will not even call them. When they reach their various homes now, you see the governor start calling, sir, they will call Asorok, call their Alhaji slave masters. Why are not do us like this now? They say, shut up, we do you what? If you see how they used to harass these people, when they are alone, my brother, you will not believe it. You will not believe that it is your excellency that when he comes, you respect him. You know, they used to harass them. The Fulani, their Fulani master used to harass them. Let me finish.
If I say, I want to sell us out.
Today, in the South South, we have sat here since morning to this time.
Mm-hmm.
And there is no single minister. I was telling them, I said, there's no single minister here. There's nobody representing anybody here.
Because
and six of you are there. And all of
because they call you South South, you answer. They call you Rivers, you answer. Tomorrow they will bring another set from you and create to call you Wood. Wood, you answer. Another day they will call you Bingo, you answer. You say I'm not Igbo, I'm Bingo. Why wouldn't they treat you like nothing? Because this is who you are nothing. For them, you don't exist. You are South South. Where do you call South South in this world? Is there any cardinal point? People don't understand. There is no cardinal point called South South in this world. But they call it for you because of your bad belly. You answer in order to just run away from your shadow. Why would they take you as anything? You are nothing. Anything they call you, you answer. We can say he's not able, he's reverse man. Rivers man, hey, no can I don't hear it. Oh, I don't hear this kind of thing before. I'm Rivers man. I'm not evil. I am Bayelsa man. I'm not evil. I'm Niger Delta. What they take you people as I don't know lesser human beings, pygmies from the Equatorial Forest. That is what they take. When you look at them, you sense it to them. Look at they wear their cap, wear this and that. You see very primitive human beings that only they are serving their belly. They don't care about the future of their generations. They don't care about anything. What they care is about their stomachs, nothing more. And their political position. Their children, nothing more. Their immediate children, they don't care again.
What are here?
Listen.
We are going to take a decisive decision.
Oh, yeah.
The federal government of Nigeria have taken this decision because there is no way, there is just no excuse at all. There is nothing happening in Nigeria, if it is not happening in the Niger Delta, that will call off such a meeting, then there is nothing happening anywhere in Nigeria, no matter the excuse that they have sent down to users.
This is what we continue hearing. But they are treating you like sub-slaves, even not complete slaves, sub-slaves. Because you answer anything they call you. You are not decisive, standing your ground and say, look at who we are. You have no right to give us names, our names. Look at who we are. Because of your wickedness, your evil intention, everything, just you want to run away from your shadows. That is why they treat you like that. You understand? If you are with your people in a bunch, that the item, they cannot try it now. They cannot try it. But you remove yourself so that if they give you at least 1 million naira, that 1 million naira, only two of you will share it instead of sharing it with other people, make it five people, you know, everybody will get to 200,000. But if you share it with only two of you, you will get 500. That is only 10. You are running away from your channel. Very greedy, selfish, and helpless set of human beings I've ever seen. That is why they treat you as a like. They treat you as a like. Imagine there is Southern Governors Forum or Southern politicians together. Who is that sort of to come and treat them, keep them waiting? Who is that? Who can do that? But they corner you, they separate you from your brothers, and you accept it because you are evil. That is why they can treat you as they like, as they are treating you. People, all the Neanderthals in the southeast, they will laugh, say, "Oh, look at you, it's south." Tomorrow they will treat them too. Oh, these other people will be laughing because these are primitive Neanderthals. Don't mind them. You look at them, you think that they went to school, they went to Harvard. They don't have common sense. They are still primitive. After all, if you go to Harvard, you can see gorilla in their zoo, won't you? That is it. Being in Harvard doesn't mean going to have a PhD doesn't make you a normal human being. When you reason and they call you south, you answer. That is the time you prove to the Fulanese that you are nothing, because there is no cardinal point in this planet Earth that is called south. That is why they treat you as nothing, because you are nothing.
I got a call from the villa. Very unfortunately.
Before it was, let me say, before.
I got a
Then Before, this is an incomplete.
Nothing happening anywhere in Nigeria, no matter the excuse that they have sent down
and
to you.
Look at your environment.
I got a call from the villa.
Mm-hmm.
Very unfortunately,
mm-hmm.
and spoke with the chief of staff to Mr. President.
Mm-hmm. Even if happy to speak with the chief of staff to Mr. President. When you are looking, you know, he's very happy because you are looking at him as a governor, but he is just simple, primitive Neanderthal. I'm telling you, any man, he is, because they always try to run away from their shadow. That is why they train them anyhow. Imagine that the whole Southern governors are gathered together. Say, no, they treat them like they cannot. Now they bring down Nigeria under 24 hours. Can you do this to the, imagine Jonathan, during the time of Jonathan in office, they're not enough. They gather for you to come and have a meeting with them. You don't go there. They'll bring you down under, you can't try it now, because they know the importance of being unified, unity of purpose. But all these people from Equatorial Forest, I don't know where, they don't reason. Because this one want to enter into political office, he want to be a governor. So anything at any cost can happen. Let it be, even if killing his own villager, every of his own community can do it. Because they are so primitive and ignorant. I don't have single respect on any of all these political animals. I don't have no single respect for them, honestly. No single one. I look at them and say, it doesn't matter what they do, it doesn't matter who they are. I look at them as lower human beings. That is how I look at them, and that is who they are. You say that they are treating you like this as nothing, because you are nothing. What is south? You are answering Niger Delta. Because the Fulani call you Niger Delta. You say, yes, we are Niger Delta. They call you Rivers. And you say, yes, I'm Rivers. Tomorrow they'll call you Stone. You say, yes, I'm Stone. Oh, Stone State. I'm from Stone. You're a miserable human being. That is who you are. Why would they take you serious? You think that Fulanis, they are like you? You think that they don't have sense? Look at this one. I have a car from a villa. You know, very happy that even he have a car, that even they give him an audience to call, to cancel the meeting. Otherwise, they would have even kept him there longer without even talking to them. But he's happy that at least even he have a call, the villa, and they pick. And they say, okay, we have canceled. After staying more than 3 hours.
And he did ask
God Almighty
that I should please apologize to the South South that they are already there at the airport. He's there at the airport with the ministers. But because of the emergency meeting and the further meeting of Mr. President with the Inspector General of Police and the DG SSS, that it will be difficult for them to come for this meeting without these two persons in their midst. In fact, I believe that at that moment I was very confused.
These are to mellow them down. Do you see how they work? Because all of them are agents. All of them are serving different masters, Fulani masters. Do you know that Southeast, South, South, so-called, the governors and their political representatives, their highest lobbying place is Abuja. They can never go outside, abroad, to USA or to Europe to lobby for their region. No. The same way the North, the Fulanese do, using North. They lobby for themselves. Do you see that? Because these people, they are ceiling. Their limit is Abuja. They go to Abuja to take instructions. All of them, both South, East, South, South. All of them. As slaves, they are. But their masters used to go as a bunch of sent representatives. They can go lobby White House. They can go lobby European Union on their own. For Northern Nigeria, remember when, is it the president of World Bank came? And the presidency charged him to do everything for the development of the Northern, concentrate on Northern Nigeria. It was mentioned, pump and play. And the Southerners, they were there looking like lower human beings, pygmies. From, I'm not even insulting, this is insult to pygmies, I'm telling you. I don't know what to refer them to, or what to refer them with. Because these people, they are a disgrace to our race. They are simply a disgrace. This is not who we are. We are a nation that's supposed to be high. But these people have sold us, Toro. They have sold us penny to the Fulani. The Fulani no more have respect. Do you understand? When you talk about tribes, people laugh or people take it and say, tribalism. Why shouldn't you be a tribalist? This is who you are. Do you know that countries in Europe, they are made up of, it is their tribes. Every country in Europe is made up of their ethnic group, their most ethnic group. Albania, they have Albanians as their ethnicity, as their tribe. They are living in Albania. Do you understand? Every other tribe is very minority, 3%. Albania, 82.58% of Albanians, that is their tribe, their ethnic group. Austria, 91% Austrians, is their tribe. Now, why should you be, don't be tribalistic. The Europeans understand this, that is why they separated countries according to their tribes or nations. It's only mostly in England that you have different nations in one country. Do you understand that? Different nations, Wales. You have Scotland. You have Northern Ireland. Do you understand? But they negotiated to stay together. They have their terms. They have their different governments. They have their final, their money. They play their footballs differently. Don't you see Wales playing against England, Ireland playing against Scotland? Don't you see that during qualifications? But they are in one country. Because a country can make up different nations. And nations make up countries. That is tribes. But the tribes, where it is good is that people will negotiate. These tribes, they should negotiate. They have to negotiate how they can live together. That is what is lacking in Africa. We are forced by foreigners in order to live. That is why there will be no development in Africa until we go to these core basic issues. The politicians are shying away. They want us to keep it like that. No, don't say it. No. Let us continue as it is. You can't change anything. You can change something. I tell you. During the Dark Ages in Europe, somebody started the movement. Somebody wrote a book. Even I think Isaac Newton is a monk. Those people that started this reformation about enlightenment through the book somebody wrote, Two Kingdoms. Is there the people started reading it and started thinking, yes, this man is right. Now the enlightened, they didn't spread like wildfire. Because before, people were thinking that, look, we are just subjects to the monarch. Oh, the Pope is infallible. He is being sent by God. So anything he says is divine. So don't talk. If the Pope or your religious leader talks, please don't talk. If you talk, you'll be killed. Or if you talk, you are talking against the Holy Spirit. You are talking against God. The same system that is happening in that quagmire called Nigeria today. They will see a so-called clergyman shitting his pants. They will tell you, no, don't talk. He's a man of God. Don't judge him. Oh, he's a man of God. You want the wrath of God to fall on you? Oh, don't judge him. Oh, God Almighty, you are in a dark age. Do you understand that? You are in a dark age. You need enlightenment. When enlightenment entered in Europe, they started having revolutions. People's eyes started being opened that, look, we should be all equal as human beings. The word of man should not be referred as the word of God. No, it's the word of man. Monarch came from a human flesh. The same thing every other person came out from a woman body. Born like an ordinary person. Why should he be referred to as God instituted him? Now the Europeans went on rampage. That was revolution. And that is the starting of the good things to come. People suffered, but people now are enjoying. Africans are now trying to go to where it is already done. Do you see? Do you see why I call many Africans, I call us primitive Neanderthals? Instead of us to start changing, trying, do something to change things, change your status quo. Change things for better. No, you go where it is already done. That is where you go. I say the white people, they are light-hearted. They are good. It would have been good even to leave Africa to continue being in the old age, whereby no locomotive, no electricity, no car. They are good. It would have been good even to leave Africa to continue being in the old age, whereby no locomotive, no electricity, no car. They are good. It would have been good even to leave Africa to continue being in the old age, whereby no locomotive, no electricity, no car. They are good. It would have been good even to leave Africa to continue being in the old age, whereby no locomotive, no electricity, no cars. They are good. It would have been good even to leave Africa to continue being in the old age, whereby no locomotive, no electricity, no cars. They are good. It would have been good even to leave Africa to continue being in the old age, whereby no locomotive, no electricity, no carpet. They are good. It would have been good even to leave Africa, to continue being in the old age, whereby no locomotive, no electricity, no cars. They are good. It would have been good even to leave Africa, to continue being in the old age, whereby no locomotive, no electricity, no cars. They are good. It would have been good even to leave Africa, to continue being in the old age, whereby no locomotive, no electricity, no carpet. They are good. It would have been good even to leave Africa, to continue being in the old age, whereby no locomotive, no electricity, no carpet. They are good. It would have been good even to leave Africa, to continue being in the old age, whereby no locomotive, no electricity, no carpet. They are good. It would have been good even to leave Africa, to continue being in the old age, whereby no locomotive, no electricity, no cars. Yes, welcome back. This is Radio Biafra House of Service coming to you through Radio Biafra, London. I don't know what happened. The system just went off and it's now reestablished. I don't know. Sometimes all these things can happen, but we are back. So, as I was saying before, the Europeans, because of enlightenment, they charted a system or their systems in a very organic and convenient way by making their nations to be their countries. Do you understand that? Whereas they come to Africa to force people to live together. They force people to live together inorganically, and we accepted it. That is the problem. We shouldn't have accepted it. Immediately they are living, normally immediately they were living. Africans should have charted their own program. Do you understand that? But because of ignorance, greed and selfishness, many of these people that charted their president, independence, they are just looking to be on the head, to be ruler on the new country, instead of going back to the basics. They didn't do that, and that is what we are suffering. And if care is not taken, unless Biafra comes, let me tell you, black Africans will continue suffering for the next 1,000 years. I tell you, because because what is that? The Europeans have mastered the plan of holding Africans down.
They tell you, oh, this is a good democracy, democracy.
What they impose as democracy is election, or selection as you call it. They keep everybody busy with the election. Every 4 years or every 5 years, oh, opposition say this, oh, they are killing human rights, oh, they are making, okay, they don't go, the circle is going on, it's a cycle, going on and round and round and round and round, no progress. They use another system of election, democracy. They use it to hold everybody down. They don't talk about the real issue. The real issue is industrialization, is development. Industrialization. Able to produce what you use, what you consume. No, they don't talk about it. Every time it's the election, democracy, people go into office, start looting, stealing, keeping money for their election to buy people, because that is what it is. Do you understand the difference? Nations and countries. Europeans, they are very smart. They made sure that no matter how small the ethnic, their tribe is, they leave it, they form it, you become a separate organic country. Whereas there are different tribes in a country, now they make it so loose, like in Switzerland, like in Belgium, that anybody can go in the federated unit, whereby you can go at any time you want. Live and let live. That is what we are saying. The basis of performing Nigeria, it is baseless. No Nigerian, you know, in the interview, between Dele and our leader Mazi Nnamdi Kanu. He told Dele, he said, had it been Nigeria is being formed by a Yoruba man, even a Fulani man, or an Igbo man, or an Ijo man, it would have been palatable. But for a fact that foreigner come from thousands of kilometers without minding our sensitivities, without minding who we are, and joined us together by force that we must stay together, his first marriage. And today, if there is any, you know, people seek asylum for forced marriage, lying. Oh, well, you know, they gave me as a wife to somebody I did by force. That's why I run away to Canada. I come here to Canada in order to seek asylum. And they will pity you, they will give you, grant you asylum. But we have been in forced marriage in Nigeria. And people don't understand this. That is the basis of what we are doing. Albania is a country. By the nation, their tribe is Albanian. Albanians, inhabited by Albanians. It's a European country. Some countries, like the other that I told you, some countries are as little few as less than 50,000, but it's a country. Because they don't want some friction that will hinder progress. Everybody progress as you want. Akan tribe is in 1 point something million. They are more than to form a country. They are more than enough to form a country. What about the Biafrans? We say we are going to form nation states, whereby each clan in Biafra land will have their own parliaments, will have their own national anthem, will write their law in their own language. Don't you understand that? That is nation state. Whereby if your nation fails, if your tribe fails, you don't blame it on other tribe. If Igbo tribe fails, you don't blame it on Ijo. If Ijo tribe fails, you don't blame it on... And everybody controls their natural resources. You just pay little tax to the center, only. Any day anyone say, no, I want to be independent. I want to be absolute independent. We do feasts and do send-off parties for you. Say bye-bye, hallelujah. That is how it should be. And that is the organogram I see, and I know that Biafra will be a success story. Because when you see, like even Kwame Nkrumah, he's a great leader, a Pan-Africanist. But do you know one of his failures? When part of that Togo land in Ghana, they were agitated to join back to Togo, their people. Kwame Nkrumah descended heavily on them. That is a very good, big mistake. You fought for independence and you want to impose others. You want to impose others to be under you. Do you see? That is why I see, you know, the Biafra is, it will be a different thing altogether. The same thing to Patrice Lumumba of Congo. When he was, he is a very, very great king, leader. But they use this Katanga. It's a breakaway nation in Congo. It's called Katanga. Led by one is it Moise Tshombe. They say they want, okay, if Congo is independent, we want to be independent also. And Patrice Lumumba descended heavily on them. Now the Europeans use it as leverage in order to kill him, to assassinate him, that they don't want these people to be independent. They supported these people. Do you see that? Had it been, these people are wise enough, they would have, any person that wants to come and say, okay, bye-bye, oh, thank you, hallelujah, they do send off. That is what Biafra is, because we want to take that test of unity first. Now, everybody, once we run Biafra the way we are running it, if you say you don't want it, everybody will be semi-autonomous. You make your law with your own language, with your own language, so that somebody from market woman will understand the law. It's no more in English. It's in Ijo language, in Igbo language, in Igala language, in Idoma language, in Urobo language, so that everybody will understand it. It's not what they are doing in Nigeria. The law, they go to interpret the law, even when the lawyers and the judge talk, even ordinary people don't understand, they will clap without understanding. They will put the Greek and the Spanish and the French inside it. Oh, ab initio, ex parte cause. This and all these are just to deceive people. People don't even understand what it means. But they clap. Oh, this one, oh, now you read, oh, read, oh. That is stupidity. That is stupidity. People running the government, they don't even know. They don't even understand. But Biafra, we are going to give example. We are going to live exemplary, so that any, if for example Urobo tomorrow, after we have Biafra, Urobo tomorrow say no, we want to be a country of our own, we even go dance with them, kiss them goodbye, hallelujah, we say goodbye, thank you very much, and they become independent. Because you cannot fight for independence, now you subdue others. Why? What is the need for it then? What is the need? You made your laws in your own languages. Everybody will understand. There will be no more cheating. Because when you interpret the law, when you read the law, you can, in the language you speak, even the grandfathers in the village speak it more than you. So how are you going to lie? How are you going to lie? But when you speak English, these foreign languages that the people don't understand, you use it to deceive. That is what I'm saying today. That is why I talk about nations and countries. Nigeria is horrible today because it's a conglomerate of nations and tribes, ethnic groups, that we are forced to live together. That is it. Now I'm going to stop here so far. And I'm going to go on break, after which I will open my lines so that people will start calling in. But before I stop, please, there is this news of which we know, these cows that are dying. Fulani cows that are dying, maybe they contract diseases. They are dying. And they are secretly selling it to our people. Listen, what we are telling you is to save your life. Do not be like what they say you are. You become like that. It's very sad. When they say you are long throat, it's not hunger. People talk about hunger in the land. No, it's long throat. You cannot, because there is hunger in the land, you go and eat poison and sell it to others. Say you are doing business or you are making money. You are a killer. That is not a miracle. Do not be deceived. When you go and buy all these dead cows, diseased cows, now you start selling it to people. Maybe cow that is supposed to be 100,000, you bought it 10,000. Start butcher, start selling it. Say you are making money. Your miracle is there. You are a killer. Let me tell you, our people should stop desist from eating cows for now. We have been saying this. You all this, you eat it, you not know it will cause you disease and you infect another person and your family, you will be dying. You will go to your daddy Joe, he will tell you that look, that your uncle at the village is the cause of your problem. Bringing divisions in our families today. So our people should stop eating, buying and eating cows. After all, red meat is not even good. I'm telling you, red meat is not even good for your health. Instead, you eat chicken, you eat white meat and fish. Stop eating cows for now. It has diseases. Please. This is where I'm going to stop. Let me go on a few minutes break and I will come back to open my lines so that people will call it.
Hey guys, yo, yeah. The tapana, the highest sacrifice is blood, because blood is life. All the killers, all the innocent blood, man, then I'm not getting on his shiny, that's all for follow. They can go back because they are not the same. That is because we judge them. And we all know it's just an apology. We have our language. We have our culture. We have everything about us. And the way we worship our God, to put Kadama by name, is what? Because everybody must just listen very attentively, because I want an Akreka. I will talk about a Loka. What you are talking about is the next generation to come, where they will live. What will you post to live for the next generation to come? And you can go every time a generation now, with the FBI and I can be up for a Teresa, who can have a governor. Senator, what can you profit to you? Everybody should join our leader. Let America stay their place. See, corrupt people, whatever they are, whatever, even if Obama, like, let them remove stuff and etc. Obama, the truth remains that we pure country everywhere. We scrapless inside their politics. Come cut away. We are pure France, we are here. We are not Yoruba, we are not Hausa. Let's be pure France. First thing. Chapter 20. Verse 20 is very, very important. Every verse, very, very important. And first Kings, chapter 21. Remember the rule. Okay? They are telling us that when I don't even know, let us come and take one after. Let us see. After that. My father, when the first of us, we have one for call.
Mazi, please round up, please. I have many people calling. Please round up.
Mazi, don't have to do again.
Don't do again.
Chapter 13, very, very important. Jeffrey Project is what is to cause the cabin. I'm going to let you do that. Kaga says in the cake. At that temple is the pure guy. All he did for the competition. Kaga no dog, they are whiter than white, as whiter than snow, like dead in the card, always so forward, they so for the madam. All of us are fragged up. All them not like it is.
Thank you. Thank you very much. Thank you, Master. Thank you very much. Caller, and what's up? Your name and where you calling from? Thank you for holding on. Please go on, Mazi. Can you hear me?
Thank you, sir. Yes, I can hear you, sir.
And welcome to the program, Mazi. Isaiah, please hold on. I'll come to you. Go on, go on.
Yeah, Odo Chineke Diregi, Ma Chineke. You have said it all, but we will still chip down some things of our own mind, because all your analysis is very, very... begging him to come from Igbo, but we are trying to let him know that he has to classify, I mean clarify people on what he's saying, the area he's going, so that at least when you convince somebody with your logic, then the person will follow you. I ask him, Wike, where is your ethnicity? I hope he must have heard it, but I know. So, my brother, this meeting they had, I had the outcome of the meeting. I mean, when Wike was saying that the presidency will apologize to them, you are begging somebody to apologize to you on what he did against you. Or instead of you to wait to hear from, I mean, to know what the person will say or what he will do, you're now begging him to show you that these people have mellowed, I mean, they have reduced themselves to 0%. But because of the fact that they're hating Amone Kanu with all the truth that he has been leashing, he has been telling them, look at these people. Fulani is not people that you meander with. As long as they have used Wike, and they know that Wike is a strong man in Niger, whatever Niger Delta was outside, what they call it. They made use of this man to kill his own. Now, Wike has done the evil. Even the northern, what they call this man, Shetima, he congratulated the man that what he did is right. They were happy. But the same people that are saying you did good, they disappointed you in a meeting that you hold. You call them to come and join in a meeting, but they disappointed you because they have known that you are evil. As a slave, yes. They treat exactly. So, my brother, as long as these people continue to hate their own, they'll continue to diminish. That is the summary of it. Okay, look at South border. South border has been closed for last year, I think last year November, till date. None of them, all this South or Southwest or Southeast, none of them have gathered together to deliberate on this issue. Why this border should be closed since November last year till this date? Now we are November again, and the border is still closed. But the border in the north is working efficiently. to date. Why these people cannot learn from their mistake, even if they don't know. But somebody that Elohim has brought to teach you, look at the way forward. You will have concluded to hate the person to the core, whereas the person is telling the truth. They will say that the way he talk, why can't he talk like that? Because you people have failed us woefully. There's no area that we will say that you people have done well. Even to date, they are still doing the same mistake. But all I know is that what goes up must come down. As long as this issue has come, Biafra issue, we must reach the end. And we must get what we are looking for. There's nothing any human being can do that. Okay, we can say that he's going to announce the day that he will travel. We are waiting to announce the date, not to say it on their mouth. Let him announce the date that he will travel. That one is not something that we put mouth for now. But we are still waiting for him to announce the date that he will travel. Simple as ABC. So, Mazi, I have to conclude for others to come and hold their own quota. Because if I start talking now, I will exhaust the whole time that the others will use to talk. Thank you so much and God bless. Thank you. Thank you. Yeah.
Yes, Mazi Jonathan, can you hear me from here? Good evening. Thank you very much, my brother. You are doing such a great job. Your analysis is spot on. Anyone, you know, missing a broadcast sometimes, missing a lot in this quest for the Biafra Restoration, you are doing with a man as the other brother from the house. You guys are doing very good, and I must thank you, and I must be appreciative of what you're doing. Keep it on, my brother. One thing I just want to emphasize here that is much, much important to me is this new development now we are seeing on social media about the dying cows, you know, and our people need to pay attention. I believe the thing that is killing the cow can kill our people in a mass if that manages to get into our people. So we need to warn our people worldwide, both in Biafra land and on the coastal region, because the guy, the interview I watched the flame man giving was saying that, you know, they moved their cattle from the upland to the riverine areas. So it's very, very important for our people to know that whatever that is killing the Fulani cows, and these people have no remorse, and they brought the dead cows to the town to sell it to our people to eat. And the man that is saying it is not even, saying that the cow. He said that they have to sell it to the community, and it causes no harm to our people. You know, if not the intervention of some group of people who spotted the dead cows, the way they packed them in the, you know, pickup and all that, they would have sold the whole cows into the community. And there are people who start dying ministerial that as we are seeing the coronavirus now rampaging everywhere. So that's why I wanted to say a little bit on that. And based on what your analysis here, what Mike have done, do you see how cool he became today after that disappointment from Fulani? Do you see how quiet he was sitting there like a hopeless animal? You know, he now realized, he starts feeling the mess he got himself into. I was watching the video, the body language, and I said, "Now, Mike, you are getting, this is only just the beginning." And this is what I keep saying, Mark. I keep saying this, and you have said this as well here several times. Our people don't know how to play politics. When it comes to politics, they are zero on it. They don't understand what politics is. and look at the ordinary ganja weed from Tutajalon, Mali, from Chad, how they are playing our people. Look at Nike today asking that the presidency have to attend an apology to them. Okay, so what that means, if the presidency, according to them, send that apology to them, now they will come back and they will start from the top. What would apology be? Okay, so what that means, if the presidency, according to them, send that apology to them, now they will come back and they will start from the top. What would apology be? When these people, you know, massacre our people in Enugu, we call the president, the call couldn't get through. He called the army, the call couldn't get through. He called the IG police, he couldn't reach anybody until the Fulani is killing our people in Enugu. The same thing happened in Anambra. The same thing happened in Niger State. And when these people, the same thing happened when the whole South, according to them, how they group themselves, South East gathered themselves and they invited the Fulani Ganja Weed to come and fight on hand on our youth. And look at where the position is today. You see how they are using this presidency of a thing, dangling it now between Wike and David Omahe. Do you see how they're making our people now? Now, we can maybe do my and I have to argue. Remember, the same Nike who claimed not to be evil, which he doesn't mean to be evil anyway. Now, after a little knockout, as I was heard, you know, last week, he ran to a boom stage. The same question I asked. The people that make up the coastal region of Biafra land is Igbo people. You keep migrating from the mainland. I have done some videos here in Ireland so that they can see how people move on the ocean, stop them. If people on the coastal region, if there's a overflow of sea or this tsunami that happens from time to time in the western world here, if something happens, those people that are living in the coastal region will not move up to upland because that is where they came from. People doesn't come from rivers. People don't come from the sea to settle. You come from the mainland. And then you settle and you continue moving on the ocean stops you. That is where you see the Igbo people from Igbo land, they go to the Igbo River, they stop there. And some people continue from the Igbo River until the so-called River State and Niger Delta, they are calling themselves there. These are common, it's not rocket science. It also too happening on the river's coast, on the coastal region. Then it gave up to me. That is how the fact of life. As soon as they throw knockout on him, his building, he went to the mainland, the area he claimed that he did not come from. This is the highest stupidity of the highest betrayal of all time. And look at the mass killing this guy has done. Fulani is now, which I strongly believe, the Fulani played this trick on Nike and he fell for it. He fell for it. Because they see Nike as a kind of rival from the East. But Nike, instead of Nike to take advantage of where he comes from, I use it to advance. The Fulani played trick on him. Turn him against his people, and now his people against him. Look at the very first example, the very first test now. He had a meeting with him at the very important time. The Fulani is disappointed him. That much shows him that is the fire, the first fire, first warning fire for him. They have fired the shot, the first warning fire, so that he will now know that it's less important. They have used him, they have destroyed his career now. They have come back to, what do you call this guy? The governor of Boyne State. You see how these people are playing them? Playing them like they are nobody. And till this very moment, our people have not understood how advanced the Fulani is at when it comes to this kind of politics. You need a unification of your people to be able to defeat these people. Like you rightly said, who the hell is Fulani if the whole East we are called in a meeting or to have a meeting with these people and be disappointed? Who the hell is Fulani? And you're begging them to come apologize so they will continue taking your oil for free. Now, the lot of things you brought out this evening, if I continue, taking them one after the other, I don't think the other people will come in here. Let me just, leave it here. And I want to immensely thank you for what you're doing and keep the good job. I continue to bless you. Okay, one mile.
Yes, I'm here, Mazi Jonathan. Get even from here. Yeah. Yeah, my name is Mazi Emeka. I'm calling from Indiana Police, USA. Mazi, I keep asking this question. Does it mean there is no educated person in the land of so-called South and Niger Delta? Because we have many educated people there.
Let me answer you. People used to mistake common sense to education. You can be educated and have PhD, back your PhD in 7, 8, 10, but you don't have common sense. Most of them are educated, illiterate, fools. Once you have your common sense, even without formal education, you can still navigate and know what is good and what is bad. But people think that once you can speak a good English, you are educated. That is rubbish. Fulanese, they don't even speak English, but they run everybody's lives. That's it. Go on.
Because why I'm asking this thing is that every time, best will be answering Naya Data, Naya Data. Our leader teach us everything we need to know. Go to your, this is geography, what map. You won't see nothing like a Naya Delta. Already, an iPhone explained the meaning of Delta is where water enters into the from the sea to the land. Okay? There is Delta in America, yeah. There is Delta in China. The people still hear it. There is a part of that Naya Delta. Like you said before, the Fulani, when Barack Obama is the president of America, these people used to come to the White House every day, every week. But these people call themselves. Unless they need more evil leaders and so-called South. If these people have common sense, then these people make me well for the masses. When the Mazi Nnamdi-Kanu came out, when they arrested Mazi Nnamdi-Kanu, is the best perfect time for these people call themselves evil leaders. They're supposed to have very big respect. Mazi, there's a post, one lady, Yoruba lady, post on Facebook. But many of our people fight the lady. They don't see meaning to that. He said Igbo are the fifth citizen in the Nigeria. And some people defending it. Who are defending it? How can you defend it? How can you defend it? They kill your people. They rape your people. They rape your mother in the bush. Nobody talk. Fulani cannot say Boko Haram is not a terrorist. See today. Fulani X-Men, they are under United Nations Charter. They are the most potent terrorists in the world. He said no. They are not a terrorist. But this idiot, they went to Burano, saying that the IPOB were terrorists. A terrorist working somewhere around the world. Don't you say these people don't mean well to our people? I insist on me just supporting them. Why are respectful and this man and that kind of came out? I never call Fulani okay again. These people are very, very smart because they learn good things from the Corona Master. They learn how to preserve their own culture and how to preserve the make their football culture be great. Great, great. But all the people, what do we learn for the white people? Are the bad things. body and a food eating junk food. Eh? Eating junk food, don't learn nothing. Tell me Fulani answering Angela. Tell me Fulani answering Linda. But you say an evil person, we both tell you, don't come and speak in evil name. Don't speak evil to my Pikin. But Fulani, they learn how to have their own dignity. Like the one who knows the white people, respect them. That's the right to respect them. But this so called educated, irritated, full of jealousy everywhere. Everywhere jealousy. Because unless they were people refuse to dance with the Kensa, that is the agent today. Eh? Come on dance. Eh? Dance, is it by force to dance? Look at the ways, how the world destroying everywhere. And you people say abandon property. After abandon property, after well. Kensa Lua, that points the African war. The same hang him to death. And for you to know that whatever goes around, God comes around. If you plan good, if you plan good, you see good. What people say, remember the man where, I'm not the man where. If you are doing good, you will see good. If you are doing bad, doing bad. If you are in IPOB, doing bad to your people because you are in IPOB. For a good, God will judge. That is why after 3 years, Kensa Lua died. Abacha died. All the power of Abacha died. It's not that you people should come out together and have one power. Have one power. Power, what is government? Government for the people. So what are you to? If your old man fighting, I'm not supposed to. Who are you going to who is that when you are old? Foolish people. Eh? Mass, what you say is the pure truth. Education is different from wisdom. Some people here in this America, yeah, full of jealousy, and they don't have common sense. They don't even tell them what is going on in their land. They are just doing high service for Mazinarika, don't notice them. But they're genuine, feel comforted. Don't care what you notice them. Whatever you do, remember the mirror where, or make the mirror where, that's what I would say. Maz, thank you very much. Let me drop it.
Thank you very much. Thank you very much. Pastor Jack, please just permit me to pick this call before I bring you in on direct line. Caller on direct line, your name and where you're calling from. Caller on direct line, please. You have to streamline your submission, please. Can you hear me?
Yes, Master Jonathan. Good evening. I can hear you.
Welcome to the program. Please be streamline your submission. Because many people are calling. They will
continue to strengthen you for
you
the good work you are doing to restore our great nation, Biafra land. My name is Michael Israel Maze. I am calling from Biafra land, the land of Chukwudikadiama, the land of the ancient land. Maze, I want to thank my great leader, Maze Nnamdi Kanu, of Hamadike One of Africa, and our deputy leader, Maz Uchenmefo, may Chukwudike Adiama lead to heaven, continue to strengthen them.
Please call out on WhatsApp. Hold on, I will bring you in. Okay? Just mute your mic.
Okay. What is happening in the zoo called Nigeria? And I want to let some people know this. We don't have any leaders or leader or leader in our land. All we have is Judas. They are Judas. They are not leaders. They are all Judas. They want to take part of Donald Trump's whatever, neither data, neither rubbish. All of them, they are foolish and self-primitive, as you say. Mazi, on your analysis, I love that analysis tonight. Because you also have something that our leader has been preaching. Because when the British get to get our land, our leader, Martin Nandekano, is the only leader we have. We don't have any other leader. Any other leader is counterfeit. They are Judas. Because our leader keeps lecturing this British Martin Nandekano that when the British came, they saw that we are the children of God. They saw that we are the people that Elohim, the blood. So that is why when they hand us over, they put it away. Because we are telling something on that analysis that the people screaming have given the people hand and control idea that it has been little good. But the hand us over, because they thought that we are the light of the world. Because they thought. Will become good by the integration of Nigeria, that everybody is better. But they don't want to do it. They keep saying one Nigeria. Yeah, we don't want America or one Canada or one UK before. They keep deceiving themselves. But what I want to say is this.
Maazi, Pastor Jack, please, the platform is yours. Welcome to the program. And after you, I will pick somebody I keep on WhatsApp also. Pastor Jack, are you there? Can you hear me? Thank you very much for patiently holding on. Thank you very much. Caller on WhatsApp, please continue holding on. I'll come to you. Go on, Pastor Jack.
Thank you very much. My name is Pastor Jack. I'm calling from Lagos as usual. First of all, I want to remind Biafrans, and more especially our volunteer, that our dragon flag is still up. It's still up. And the reason why I say this is the Gandawin army are colliding with the close puppet clamoring for position for 2023, which they don't know if they are going to be alive to see 2023. But I've said they are coming down again with the Operation Python Dance, the 6th or the 7th. So I want to remind
Operation Crocodile Smile.
Crocodile Smile, I mean to say, anyone, if they like, they could name whatever thing they want. But we want to remind them that our dragon flag is the on. And we tell them the stand we are made of, because enough is enough. Now, having said this, we are not backing down on anything. In case you do not know, most of these idiots ranting, deceiving you with their cross-carpeting, trying to heat up the politics so that your arm will be taken off the ball. Do not give them the attention they desire. Don't give them. All of them, they are puppets. Exception of this idiot that don't know his identity, who says he's not an Igbo. I remember IPAB died for this idiot. Defended this idiot. Does everything for this idiot. And even army people were carrying ballot boxes invested everything. IBO been defended these idiots. And today, he joined a group of prophets that pay allegiance to the caliphate. Now we know in our land, in the entire Biafra, whether upland, whether in farine area, none of them is answerable to the people. None of them is answerable to the masses. They are only answerable to the prophet. But one thing we must do, we must have to stop them. We must have to look for a way to stop these people, either by omission or by collision. We must look for a way to stop them. These people are cankerous. The slave master can no longer directly come to enslave you, but they will use those you call your leaders, those that call themselves the ruling class, those that call themselves the elite. They will use those people to oppress you. The worst oppression in this surface of the earth is when your own leader or your own person, your own brother or sister is oppressing you. Another person using that person to oppress you. That is the worst form of oppression. If you go anywhere, they will tell you, but it is the people that is leading you. It is not outsiders. How come you are complaining? But there's something you must do. If you don't rise up to stop them at all costs, you will remain, you will perpetually continue to be a slave. They will continue to torment you. They will continue to be a thorn in your flesh. It's only when you rise and do something to stop them that you can be able to scare them away. Yes, a weekend and the likes of you. Don't just panic. Something bigger will visit each and every one of you. And in this 2023, you people will know. If you people are going to be allowed to campaign in the whole of Biafra land, we shall know. We are going to know. They can use you for all they want. For so far, you have killed 2,083 people in all people. You can never go scot-free. If you like, be carrying Dele Mahmoud all around, paying his flight and all that to be covering your jaguar, talking nonsense. Hey, as I'm a trusser, I'm coming. But one thing I want to tell all of you, if you like, cross-carpet to water party or any other idiotic party you want to cross-carpet, Biafra will chase all of you out of our land because we never elected any of you. We never elected any of you. We don't believe in your leadership. God is the only king we have. We don't know you, and we must do everything to stop all of you because you have brought death. You have brought insanity. You have brought suffering. You have brought devastation. You have brought death and massacre into our land. Our land is being disgraced by you people. We must do everything to stop you people at all costs. If not, our people will continue to die. And therefore, call on all the Biafra. Do not relent. Do not relent. Continue to blow the fire. Ignite the fire to keep the fire burning. Making sure that in the end, Biafra shall come in our time. It doesn't matter how long it's going to take. It may be now, it may be any time. But be rest assured, Biafra is an ideology that all of us has conceived. And nobody can change that fact from us. It doesn't matter where we are. Anywhere we are, it does not change anything. We believe in the ideology of Biafra. And we will continue to work in any means possible to make sure we work towards the resolution of Biafra. No matter man can stop this ideology. If you like key, everybody wants to key, but he cannot key the whole of Biafra on the surface of the earth. If only one man remains, that man will continue to clamor for Biafra until the day Biafra is restored in our time. Master Jonathan, that is all I have to contribute this night. Thank you very much.
Thank you. And God bless Biafra. And you too, Pastor Jack. Thank you very much. We must move on. Caller on WhatsApp, thank you for holding on. You are a patient man. Your name and where you're calling from, please, if you may. Can you hear me?
Yes, I can hear you, sir.
Good evening, sir. Welcome to the program. Thank you.
Hey, thank you very much, sir. I'm Kelechi Crew Manuel Wokwa. I'm calling from Putnovo right about now. I just want to appreciate Mazen and the Carlo Magoa. I hope you are part of
Inyanyi Neme, because it should be Inyanyi Neme.
Yes.
Okay.
Yes, very high name, of course. Thank you. Thank you for the correction. You for the correction, sir. So, one, very happy. And I believe that Biafra will come to pass someday. The caller had called before the pastor called. I really appreciate what he said, because when you put that, people should stop eating cow. You understand? Biafra, it come to pass in our mindset. Very, very important. Now we are talking about Echarela, that our people are busy buying lands in Lagos, building, having businesses. While we have East, they are where they can go and develop their shops, open shop. You understand? Now, I was afraid to you. I'm on with one when I was a Fulani this evening. I'm not the guy when I was a Fulani. He claims to be a Yoruba guy. So we are saying something, and the guy was, I never knew. This one, the kind of hatred in that Raven Dibon, my brother, I was like, I was shocked today. I think he should have gone on top of that. I'm not on your Fulani. I was even believing that the guy was from the West here. You understand? So, you want to actually contribute to that is that our people who are not Lagos, especially in the Lagos, they're not nuts. First of all, should start coming home. We want to actualize Biafra, and they are there. We have to actualize this Biafra in our mindset. Very, very important. Stop buying their goods, such as cows. Oh my, my, and because this one can poison this meat. And even if you now want to, if you say it's not Pagano in a village, I listen to everything you say this evening. You understand? So our people now was the Ibdu, my especially now Laba, Nazo and Laba, a lot of them. Stop all in your name, go to East, Nazwala, all our hand in Wuna and Lagos. You can still build the East. You can build a shop and whatever you import from abroad, you come and display it in your shop in the East. People will still buy it. After people, they should not buy Azwaya and Naba. So, Naga Ona is something that everybody needs to put their head together. Okay, that guy in Neku, we all say, okay, we want to go. And a lot of us are busy building house in Lagos. People are busy buying land. And then here, my father, Dom, I cannot tell you what, people that fought that Biafra war those days. The real men that fought Biafra war are still waiting, those of them that are still alive, that are still waiting to fight the war, if not to now. But Ega now has some men. Ega now work. I have an opportunity to meet like two men in the game. Bank tell you, or grab the game more. They go grab the game more. They did not partake in that fight. Yeah, they babare more here. Zuko and Pano Ubin. When that day he pick young boys, Gaga the uncle. They never fought. The women that have this Onono Kunobi, their path. Those people in Ahona, they are still willing to fight. Because hammer that we are being marginalized. So it's better we die for something than to live for nothing. So Biko, hear him to our people now. I want to send this message to our people. Not a Nigerian, not a Lego. Now, Biko, him to Ewa, Biko, Mazagalun, stop eating cow meat. Very, very important. Stop eating cow meat. And again, people should start coming home. Very important. Start coming home. Build houses, set up your business in okay, this boy now we also from Nangwagamaya today. Oh God, that the Igawa that he served in East. Now he got a lot of lock up shop after that was on the chat, main market. The chat people locked up. When did they use here and all of us are busy and thoughts roaming about? Look at what we hear now Jupupu. Last time my other Lagos, he wouldn't believe. Look at the trade fair. So our people were one of the problems I didn't win. So because I question just at this gym in our mindset, first of all. Now Martin and the Karupu something that now this one would when you arrested. Because you know you may so you can shut this you can shut up with this of everything. Yeah, give us international seaports, give us the international airports. And they refuse to give it to us. So tell me why these people are refusing to give us international seaport, international airports. Because they know that if they do that, Lagos will fall. They know. Now you are this nation. They know. Oh, so these people in Ahona, they are very bad people. We are being marginalized. So I believe that one day this Biafra will come to pass, and I am a Biafra commando. Anywhere I am, I don't talk much about my own action. go pilot or not. And for them, they are not going to East. Uno, Padu, Uno. Me working, he did children working, he got going, he did children working, those are equal like a police in Hungary because in the East, you were police is doing with the common jackknife. Yeah, once to go. This Agalam said more than two times in Umebule, police station. Because of they caught me with a jackknife. They say get him jackknife. It's was flung in the put Hanu could make it for terror. Gary, when it there. So we have to start making this thing compact in our mindset.
Thank you.
We have to start making this effort compact in our mindset.
Thank you very much.
Because I'm not going to pass. The effort must come to pass. Our mindset, let it come to pass. Leave Lagos. Develop your land. You put everything on the again, maybe cotton again, Lagos or Pachao, I would do you book the Lagos. Eat Tiana Trella, Putiana or the Chamema, Topiana Badia.
Thank you.
I think it was seaports. You could have all federal projects. My eye, I bet you take it. All those are important are also hands short. It took you go 1 million on the child, 1 million on the child. Eh? And then you took a government mayor, you call IDB mayor, you work. I am in. Came in, I took it. Came in, man.
Thank you, my brother.
Don't do it for us. Then let's put good money and do it for ourselves. We have the money.
Thank you, my brother. I think you have made your point. Thank you.
Oh, this thing of me sometimes. Thank you very much, sir.
Thank you very much. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
God bless you and keep all of you.
And you too. Thank you very much. We must continue. The issue is this. Please call out and what's up. Hold on. Call out and what's up. Hold on. The issue is of the anyway. Let me pick the caller on WhatsApp. Continue. Your name and where you're calling from before I go on. I have somebody calling on direct line. I wanted to pick. Has been calling, but go on. Caller on WhatsApp. Go on.
Am I rising?
Yes, of course.
Good evening, sir.
Welcome to the program, Mazi.
I'm from Ifeanyi Elewuti. This is for life now. You may get to come, mother. Number eight, and you must share is a number in the candidate ever, literally become. So, man, I'm asking you to tell me with the information I have to call the line. The person controlling the line is not picking up. Want to know if there is another number that has been released that I can know how we are many here that we are ready to.
Okay, you know what you're going to do? Please, after the call now, please inbox me. Tell me I am the person that called that wanted that number to become. Just send me one small note, okay? On this line, okay?
Okay, sir.
Yeah, and I will pick it up from there.
Thank you, sir.
Okay, thank you very much. Do that, please. Yes, this is Radio Biafra House of Service coming to you through Radio Biafra London. We are winding down because the time is fast spent. There are people that have been calling. I want to pick their calls if they call back. Like what our brother said, that people should come back from Lagos, this and that. Yes, but I know it's not easy to relocate, but we have been sounding it for people to at least extend their business. So let me pick this call. Caller on direct line, welcome to the program. Your name and where you're calling from. Can you hear me?
Good evening.
Welcome to the program.
Yeah, I'm not the minister of Baba, but I'm calling from the Republic of the State of my mother. I'm calling from Kutunu. Mother, I say they think about keep you and all of you and I'm not sure I'm just a land. All the holy representatives, all of you are making sure I keep you all of the last. On the last day, you shall march into Biafra land and celebrate. Mother, if you want, I would just want to contribute this night, my own duty. You know, in our people's mind, in Biafra land as a whole, after the war ended, those of them who were ready to do their fortune, that they finally used as a political criminal lineup in our land. They have succeeded in destroying our people. So from that time to now, no, nothing has been achieved as a particular nation, because they are not a nation. Understand? So now, our leader, God Almighty from heaven has raised our name. Let them do us back again. But these people have destroyed us. So many documents have destroyed us. That is why you can see a new able man, because by your name is dear, and the name of their community and their father and their grandfather signify which ethnicity do you come from. It don't need God to come from heaven and tell you who you are. Or somebody from North Japan to come and tell you who you are. No. By your name and name of your community and name of your grandfather. And your language signifies who you are and where you came from. So that is why a man cannot come. I will pick up the goat. They always put this in like this. I mean, you are not educated. The reason is a master planner. I said the feeling is a master planner. That's from the what? That's from the mindset. They have the brain. They have that knowledge. Particular knowledge. They have it. How to fight for their ethnic survival. They have it. How to consider us and our citizens. They don't fight in fact, they fight for their collective interest. From Gambia stands that he is the Fleming man. Fleming from the Japan to Fleming man. That's why the world in the Jews stands that I'm a Fleming by ethnicity. That's why the whole African country. But an evil man, when Gowan came to give name, from today, your name are happy. He's not jumping up. Coming that a river was built by heaven. I don't know. I want to ask this question. Is rivers an ethnicity? Is cross river ethnicity or something? Is Bayasa? Is that an ethnicity? Roman and a German. Is Bayasa ethnicity? Is rivers ethnicity? Is there any place that found the ethnicity to the anti river of the answer is no. Enemies in our land because of their selfish interest, because they are better human beings, because of their selfish interest for what they have done against their people by choosing some abandoned properties in that particular coastal region. That is why they are trying to die in ignorance, and they never know that thing because they are better human beings. That is why they are trying to live. Why they are trying to protect themselves from their own particular brotherhood? Because I think that what they have done, they have no face and the mouth and the eyes to come out and confess what they have done to their people. They're their own blood brothers. Do you see? So these are the enemies. They know what they are doing. They know what they are doing. The Obama man in the Republic here, we tell you that I'm a hero that by ethnicity. I'm not able. Because the like that speaking tribe in this Republic is people. There are another ethnicity in Europe. They get all the conventions, has it, but not a group. But he had it as a group, and he said, no, I'm better. I'm not going to say, I'm better. Do you see how our people are obedient slaves? The bad mentality of slavery is in their mind. That's why they feel like an evil man. Let me tell you something by myself. You better be an evil man. Let me tell you something by myself. Trying to deny our own time, our own local language to be that shows where it came from. So I said, cannot be their language, but they are not that family has blended their language. Because you want to belong.
Thank you.
Trying to deny the children their own language, not the only place where you came from.
Thank you, Mas.
I don't know the kind of brain that people have. They all make laughs and the children are a better planner, more than them. Before that grammar and teacher was speaking, where did that grammar leave us today? Well, we can teach you this book, but the language is speak. Where did this book, who paid us? Who paid us for this? Who this is what I'm talking today. This is where the English landed us today.
Thank you, Mazi. Thank you, Mazi. Please round up. Thank you very much. Thank you. Thank you. We must continue. I think I have somebody calling on WhatsApp and the. I picked the person. We must continue. Caller on direct line, please. Your name and where you're calling from.
Yes.
Please, I think you are going to be.
Good evening, Mazin.
Yeah, welcome to the program.
My name is Mazin Maiman Ugonye Jaka. And I am the national PRO of IPOB here in the United States of America. I reside here precisely in Washington, D.C., but I am from Amiibo. Amiibo is in Oru, and Amiibo is the home of the Tiger, and Amiibo is the home of King Jaja. Mas, I thank you so much for your analysis and for this Radio Biafra outside. I thank God Almighty for bringing Nnamdi Kanu to us, our Savior. Mazi, I am extremely very, very hopeful. And I thank God at the rate at which things are evolving every day. Biafrans are rising. Even the youth of Nigeria are rising. The people that have been used before, they are getting sense. Radio Biafra is entering and Radio Biafra is doing the job it's supposed to do. So, my advice to us, Biafra, is to concentrate on this radio and make sure that every corner of the zoo is saturated with this radio. Mazi, believe me, it's only you, the mouth, talking, and then, you know, the deed will be done. So that's what I'm saying. You know, if we check from which time that we started this problem, this program, that is Radio Biafra, and where we are now, believe me, I am so hopeful. Because we have destroyed these people. Whatever they are doing now is they are trying to see how they can amend their ways. All this thing is a struggle, you know, for a dying man. When a man is dying, then he will do everything out of desperation. And this is what they are doing. They're so confused, they don't know how to handle the what is coming to them. So the youth, please, I'm about to hand in there. And I am calling the military, the police, the soldiers, the Biafran soldiers, the Biafran in the military of Nigeria, the Obi was in the military of Nigeria, the Ali was in the military of Nigeria, and even in the indigenous middle beggars in the military of Nigeria. I am telling you that we, girlfriends, Nnamdi Kanu, we are fighting for you. We are fighting for your children. We are fighting for good life for your parents. We are fighting for your freedom. We are fighting for you to have a good life. You know, you've been created. You have been in this world since now you are born, and then there is nothing to show for it. So we are fighting and we are carrying everybody along. But most importantly, Biafra must be restored. And Biafra is where we are going, and that is where we are heading. So I am calling also on the people from South Carolina, the people from Zamfara. My, you know, good brother, the one that you anchor this with, I am telling them that there should be hopeful. The youth, I am begging you just to be hopeful and then join and listen to the Radio Biafra, because believe me, there is light at the end of the tunnel. The whole world are listening. In America now, America knows everything that is going on. CNN have just testified what happened at Lekki. CNN have carried the Lekki things, and CNN will continue to carry, you know, our program. So that's the way it's going to be. So I want you to stick in that, do what you're doing, because the whole world are saying, and this plan looking for a way that you know, they're going to use to, you know, get out of office. They want to get out of the office, but definitely it is very, very hard for them to do. So continue doing what you're doing. I pray God that God will give us long life, and then we will continue to do our good job. So for the people in the north, I want to tell you that they said yes, that you are the northern youth. They say everything, they say northern youth. But how can you be northern youth when the border of the north is open and the people who are migrating to your land are the Fulanis? All the Fulanis in West Africa. The poor Fulanis in West Africa, they open up the border for them to come. When they have the poor Amajiris that have not been taken care of, the Amajiris that are sitting on the street and walking around, nothing has been done for those children. Then still, they have the guts to open up the border and bring the Fulanis from other West Africans so that they can come. So yes, they claim that they love you. These are nothing but few gangsters. The gangsters that have hijacked the destiny of their children. They don't want to let go, but we're going to fall so that they can just give up. Their children are overseas. Their children are in America. Their children are in Britain. The work they are doing is the work of the Britain, and that is the Fulani that are doing it. I want you to know that Nigeria, you call Nigeria, you think that Nigeria is a nation or a country. Nigeria has never been a country. Remember, the British came with the name Royal Niger Company. It is that Royal Niger Company that was transformed into Nigeria. There was no way that Nigeria was formed apart from the Royal, that same company that they used to, you know, siphon our mineral resources. So when they were going, they changed the name to Nigeria. So that is the thing, and then they brought everybody together and said, oh, you are Nigeria. So we don't have anything like a nation, we don't have anything like a country. So what we are going to do is keep the pressure. They have never seen this type of pressure in life. This pressure that Nnamdi Kanu have created, honestly, they have never witnessed this type of pressure before. So we have to keep on, and then we have to focus, and we have to be consistent, and then, you know, the victory will be ours. And thank you so much, and God bless you.
And you too. Thank you very much. We must continue. I think let me take the last call. Caller on WhatsApp, your name and where you're calling from.
My name is Kisilu. We're calling you from Morocco. Mazi Jonathan.
Welcome to the program.
I want to sing a small song. Ikwere na Biafra, wike, ikwere na Biafra, wele moto akagelu. Mazi, this one is what Pericoma said. Iga ataku, oga ataku te ajamo bu konkre kwa katakwa. This is very big slap. His own right man, where they used to kill and bury the little man, all of the suddenly disappointed. Now we come to the presidency they are waiting. The chairman of the South is Ifani. They are playing with the Fulani people. You know, these people are fools. The Cross River, he said, I'm an Igbo man. He said it. Now, what are you talking about? Buhari, when he hit this our trouble, you know that the thing is very full. You people should go organize here. They are telling you people have all these politician mongers jumping like monkeys. You see, my brother, they now, these people know the feeling of the calamity of bloodshed. Is going to touch them one by one, and we move spiritually and also physically. That is my own. Because no single one will go free. The revenge and the repercussion is going to come. According to the callers, they say, what are we going to keep for our children and our future? They have been selling us out already in our crocodile eye. We are talking about the future. My dear brother, we are at war. Everybody, both Akwaibo, both Edo, Bayelsa, Rivers, Delta, all of you, you get up and ask those people, Papa or Mama, what do you bring home? You want to go and work president, what do you bring home for us? I tell you people, they will go and come back with no back. Single one, they will not bring back. But that story, apologize to the devil or apologize in heaven. Living a slavish mentality. Black Americans supposed to live down such a life. These people are living in that damn consume. In your own land. Because of what man created. Simple, the youth are coming out telling you, enough is no. People have no conscience. Keep it like that, my brother. God bless you. Keep your good work. And I ask that you do more. That is the ultimate. The fire is already here. We are inside it. Thank you. God bless you.
Thank you very much. This is where I'm going to draw the curtain for today. But before I finally close, let me bring in my colleague, my comrade, to make a closing remark before I continue. Master Jacob, can you hear me?
Yes, I do.
Okay. Just your closing remark before I continue to closing and playing the national anthems. Go on.
Okay. Thank you very much, Mark. We are very, 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 so very, 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 I can't get a job. And good night, everybody. God bless you all.
And you too, thank you very much. This is where I'm going to draw the curtain, but before I go, let me say this. You know, the topic of my submission today talk about nations, tribes, and countries. You know, when you hear about tribes, you think that it is something that is only concerned or something that is only compatible with Africans. No. Tribes are tribes. It's a social division in a traditional society consisting of families or communities linked by social, economic, religious, or blood ties with a common culture and dialect. That is tribe or nation. That is it. So, and a country is different. A country can be a nation. A nation can make a country on nations. A country, depending, a successful country and depend on the arrangement of the nations or tribes inside that country. But the terrible thing about Nigeria is that the component nations or tribes are not consulted while forming Nigeria. And Nigeria is an ethnic slur given by a foreigner, the British, and her hallowed fiancé. You understand? So that is the evil in that. Nobody was consulted before giving that name, and people with different and divergent values, we are forced to live as forced marriage. Now, what do you think that will happen? The resultant effect is what is happening in Nigeria today. Stealing, looting. To maintain Nigeria to be one, try it. Since 1960 to today, see the same story. Maintaining Nigeria to be one. Now, when is development going to come? Why can't black people reason? That is the problem. Can't you reason beyond your stomach? Because everything the black man has been fighting for, mostly for his stomach, for his immediate need. As far as he concerns his immediate need, personal immediate need. That is a problem. That is a problem we are having. That is why they can create even South-South. No, nothing like South-South, South in a map. No cardinal point called South-South in a map in this world. And that is why they treat them as nothing, because they are nothing. Really, logically, they are nothing. Because South-South is nothing. So they are treated as nothing. Do you understand that? Name matters a lot in your lives. Your name matters a lot. That is why you cannot see nobody naming his or her child as Lucifer. If you think that name doesn't matter, go and name your child Lucifer. Or name him Criminal. It's a name. Criminal. People name their children, Stone. You know, because they want, you know, something strong, you know, something hard, you know. So, but nobody names inside Criminal or Lucifer or Judas. When they name you South-South, Niger Delta, and you accept it with happiness, rejecting who you are, accepting this bizarre and fraudulent nothing called South-South. Why wouldn't they treat you as nothing? Because after all, Gabashehu would be, if you are calling him on phone, he would see your calls and say, look at these people are nothing. So why bother to treat them as human beings? Ponder this. Ponder about this. There are six geopolitical zones in Nigeria. I've said it before, but I want to reiterate, repeat. We have the Northeast, North Central, and Northwest. We have the Southeast, South-South, so-called, and Southwest. But if the northern region is doing, maybe their politicians or governors are holding meeting, they hold under one umbrella, the North. They have not East, they have not West, they have not Central, but they go under the North. They don't want to divide, separate or divide themselves into pieces so that they will have mouths, so that they will be in a bunch. But the Southerners that believe that they are all and all, they know everything, they are PhD holders, they are everything you can think of in Nigeria, they are. But the whole meeting are South-South, Southwest, Southeast, Governor Forum. They disintegrated themselves or allowed themselves to be disintegrated. And you want to make a headway politically in Nigeria. You are joking. You are joking. You are a joker, honestly. You know, we are just like a Caiman I mean, wise man that died in a foolish man's backyard. That's it. Because in the South, everybody, most politicians are interested in their personal position, their stomach, you know, their ego, their personal aggrandizement, their personal ego. They don't care about the community, the people they represent, or they should be representing. They don't care. That is why Wike will rise up and start slaughtering his own people, because he wants to be a vice president. We are watching. You know, our leader said that the Southerners are the most idiotic, and it's true. It's true. Mostly South, Biafran politicians, they are the most miserable people in politics I've ever seen. Do you know that even these politicians, even these Biafran politicians, when I talk about Biafran politicians, I talk about the South, East, and South, South. Do you know that if they had been wise, the rise of our leader, Mazi Nnamdi Kanu, would have given them the leverage they want in order to obtain everything. Even by now, they would have been begging them, "We come and take president. Okay, let them pitch one Biafran against another in Nigerian presidential election." Just like what they did during 1999. Olufalaye and Obasanjo. But these people, their selfishness and greed blinds their eyes. I'm telling you. That is why. They tell, just like they tell you, go and destroy your, what do you call it? The leverage you can use in putting money in the bank. Now destroy it, come down, the bank will give you money. Is that possible in Nigeria? Do you see how foolish they are? And they want to be politically relevant. Politics is local. When you cannot start from your people, you are deceiving yourself. I'm telling you. There is something terribly wrong in Nigeria. Nigeria is a place where nations were forced to live together by force, without them even having the opportunity to discuss, negotiate by themselves. They were forced to live together. Just as, and they continue defending it. Any person that enters office is defending the unity of Nigeria, one Nigeria. Now, that is why there is no electricity. Do you know, defending one Nigeria, do you know how many billions of dollars it takes? Do you know about it? You don't know. When we talk, you don't understand. It sucks billions of naira, billions of dollars, to defend one Nigeria. Therefore, that money that should give you electricity, that money that should go on infrastructural development, is being used in maintaining one Nigeria. Because you are not always artificial. Something that should be organic is artificial. People with opposing value systems are forced to stay together by foreigners, and you see the locals maintaining it. How do you call them normal human beings? They are not. They are just there doing the biddings of the foreign creator, nothing more. But by now, I think you've understand why we are doing what we are doing. We continue reiterating on this. We continue preaching, because this is who we are, and this is what we are doing. Therefore, I thank each and every one of you listening to my voice, or you that have listened to my voice. And I stop here so far. Tomorrow is another day. And from me, Maz Jonathan, from here, I say good evening.